I thought that there was a red light there. Is this saying recording? Okay. Well, I just wanted to make the strudel that I made last time, because I made the cherry strawberry strudel, and I used just the store-bought kind of dough. So yeah, that's, you don't really have to do anything to it. I'm just straightening it out like this, and I have a rolling pin. You don't have to flour it or add it, any extra stuff to it. So it's just going to look like this, just a squared thing. You can find this at any store. Okay, so then you just take a knife, and then you want to cut it into 4 equal squares. So just like that, just slowly, and then you cut it. So just 4 equal squares, doesn't matter if it's not equal. Like that. Okay, so this is prepared, and the oven is at 350 Fahrenheit. I already preheated it. And I have here one bowl of brown sugar, but it's only like 2 tablespoons inside. And I have a bit of cinnamon. And so I have my, I would say 7 or 8 strawberries. So I'm gonna throw them in here. Okay. So just in a bowl with the brown sugar. And I also cut my cherries, so I threw in here like 12, 13, it really doesn't matter, just a whole bunch of strawberries and cherries. If you don't have strawberries, you can just use cherries, and if you don't have cherries, you can just use strawberries for this. This is just some kind of recipe I invented for the strudels. And then for this, you just add just a tiny bit of cinnamon. So I just use the tip of my knife here. I'll just add like a small teaspoon, like a tiny, tiny bit. And just sprinkling it on top. Just kind of, just so you can see there. It's a tiny bit. And that's it. Like, don't put too much in there. Okay. Now, you want to mix this up. And when you have it mixed, then I'll show you how to add it here. So, we'll see. So, I have it here. Is it good? Mm-hmm. I have it all mixed up with the brown sugar, and the brown sugar will melt a little bit, like it'll liquefy, just because the strawberry and the cherry has juices that liquefy it, so it'll go to the bottom here, and you won't really need it. I only put the brown sugar to give it that sweet taste, but I like the cherry and the strawberry mixed together because it'll give that sweet and sour taste, and that's what I want to add for the strudels. And mainly if you have cherries that are almost going bad, but they're only bad on one side, then you can use them so that you basically use the cherries so you can cut out the good part, and then you can still use it and you can add it to this recipe. So if there's any cherries that they have like any bad sides to them, like this here, then for example, if this was the bad side, you can cut the good side out and then just use it for this recipe. So you can cut it in bite-sized pieces and just use whatever cherries you have. If you only wanted to use the strawberries, again, you can cut like the bad side out of it and then just use the good side and slice it up and then use it for this recipe. So it really doesn't matter what kind you use, and just make sure that you don't wear anything that's white, because the cherry stains a lot. So you want to protect your clothing. And now I'm going to go ahead and I just want to add some of these right into the center here. It really doesn't matter. You just, as long as they stay right in the center, and if they fall off, you can just put them back in here. So I will do that to the rest of them, and then I'll show you when you come back. Okay, so I just basted the sides with some egg wash as well. This will help give it the glue to make it stick together. So I don't have a brush, I just use this spoon, but it works just fine. And here is just a little bit of portions that I put in the center. You don't want to fill it all the way, because you want to be able to close it up. So I'm just gonna show you. You just take the edges, and you can pull this because it's a dough. And then you just pull it all the way to the center. You can stretch it out a bit and pull it all the way to the center. You can start like with these edges, and then start with the back like this. And then make sure you give it a little bit of a gap here. This here has to be just a small hole so that it has that room to breathe and explode. and this finally all the way on the top. So here I have four holes, and you take this, bring it to your pan, just like that. And I have here a greased pan, just lightly greased with butter. And just leave it like this. And it's okay if it stays open here a little bit, right here at the side. So just leave these parts here a little bit open, and they will look good as well. And that way it'll cook really, will bake really well. And do the same, and afterwards just brush it off on top with the remaining egg white, and I'll show you how it looks like. So I'm gonna do the rest of these, and then just come back just before I'm about to put it in the oven. Thanks. Okay, so this is how it looks, and I just brushed the top with the egg whites I had remaining, a little bit of egg white wash, and I'm gonna put it in the oven, and then I will be showing you how it looks like when I take it out. You just put it all the way to the center in the middle there, on the center top. So just come back when they're ready.
How they look like, and we're gonna take it out. As you see, they're done. I didn't reach for my gloves. Hang on 1 second. I have to get my mitten. Okay, we're ready to take it out now because they look good. Yeah, they might look a little exploded like this, but that's completely fine because this is how it's supposed to look. It's supposed to be all golden here. I'm gonna turn the oven off. So it's supposed to look all golden here at the sides. This is why you brush it off with the egg wash, and then it gives it this golden look, and then you know it's done. You don't really have to worry about it, and it's okay if it leaks all over here. That's why you should use aluminum. It's easy to clean up, but just give it some time to cool off because you don't want to get burned. So if you have the cranberries, you can add them. I just forgot to add them, but they give it a really good chewy taste. So try it yourself. And I will post the recipe at the bottom of my link.
And the apple turnover, and this is how it turned out. I let it cool off. And so again, I just forgot to add the cranberries, but I'm just gonna give it a try.
So good.
And look, it's so flaky. Like, it just flakes right off, so it's really easy to make. And what do I used is a dough that's from the market. It's already pre-made. It's just a puff pastry dough. So if you can find it at your local market, it's called puff pastry, and it's very easy to make. You can put anything, blueberries, any kind of berries in, and you just wrap it up like I showed you, and you can make any kind of little strudels that you like.